Does food order matter? Should I be eating carbs last? The research suggests that the order in which you consume your macros, carbs, fats, and proteins, can significantly impact blood sugar levels. It's a term called sequential nutrient ingestion, and it's been the idea that eating protein and your non-starchy vegetables before the carbs leads to a lower glucose response. Think of it as having the meat and salad first, then the potatoes last. In this video, we'll break down what the research shows us and why exactly you might want to consider food sequencing for your next meal. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick before we get started, guys, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Eating fiber first, then protein and fats, and finishing with carbohydrates could slow the speed that your stomach empties and helps lower your blood sugar levels. Because we know for a fact that eating carbs can lead to a spike in blood sugar, right? Fiber and protein don't increase sugar levels nearly as much as carbs do. That's because fiber and protein take longer for the body to digest and absorb, so they release their energy more slowly. And speaking of fiber, according to the Institute of Medicine, women under 50 should eat at least 25 grams of fiber per day, and men under 50 need at least 38 grams per day. That's because fiber plays three roles: hormonal effects, intrinsic effects, and caloric effects, which all contribute to the same result, which are often neglected since we don't consume nearly anywhere near these guidelines. But let's start with the first clue of why food order does matter, and that has to do with naked carbs. In the European Journal of Nutrition, the combination of white rice with fiber being bok choy, fat being oil, and protein being chicken yielded a significantly lower blood sugar response than white rice combined with any individual ingredient. Co-ingesting white rice with all three components attenuates the glycemic response to a greater degree than when it's eaten with any single one of them. And this is not at the cost of an increased demand for insulin. So the first clue is the way that naked carbs affect the body. The second clue has to do with the actual processing of food in the body. Fats, for example, have a very interesting mechanism that acts like protein in the fact that they are slow digesting. They actually require your liver to produce bile acids, which, guess what? It buys extra time for your small intestines because they need to send chemical signals to your stomach. That does something interesting. It tells your stomach to reduce gastric emptying, which is a measure of time that it takes for food to empty out of your stomach, which is just fancy for pumping the brakes on digesting. The Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism hinted at this in this randomized crossover study, where ingestion of fat before a carbohydrate meal markedly slows gastric emptying and attenuates the postprandial rises in glucose, insulin, and GIP, but stimulates GLP-1 and type 2 diabetes. And we all know what else stimulates GLP-1. But are two clues enough to point out that carbs should be eaten last? They needed to put an actual test to this, and sure enough, they did in this Journal of Diabetes Care. They took 11 patients, all of whom have type 2 diabetes and are on metformin, to see how food order impacted post-meal glucose levels. They had the patients eat a meal consisting of carbohydrates, ciabatta bread and orange juice, protein, vegetables and fat being chicken breast, lettuce and tomato salad with low fat dressing and steamed broccoli with butter, twice on separate days a week apart, right? On the day of their first meal, researchers collected a fasting glucose level in the morning, 12 hours after the patients last ate. They were then instructed to eat their carbohydrates first, followed 15 minutes later by protein, vegetables, and fats. After they finished eating, researchers checked their post-meal glucose levels via blood test at 30, 60, and 120-minute intervals. With me so far? A week later, researchers again checked patients' fasting glucose levels and then had them eat the same meal, but with the food order reversed. So protein, vegetables, and fat first, followed 15 minutes later by carbohydrates. The same post-meal glucose levels were then collected. The results are very interesting in that it showed that glucose levels are much lower at the 30, 60, and 120-minute checks by about 29%, 37%, and 17% respectively when vegetables and protein were eaten before the carbohydrates. Insulin was also significantly lower when protein and vegetables were eaten first. That's exciting news. But I get it. That was just 11 people. We need a bigger sample size. Well, the closest thing we have to that was a 2019 study that took 16 healthy Chinese adults at this time. And they were served a series of meals that included meat, vegetables, and white rice, a typical Asian diet. The highest blood sugar levels were seen when people ate rice first, followed by the other dishes. Isn't that interesting? Blood sugar was significantly lower when people ate all three dishes together, but the lowest blood sugar levels followed a sequence of vegetables first, then meat, then rice, called VMR. Vegetables, meat, then rice. In other words, leading with vegetables or fiber and saving carbs for last seemed to blunt the carbs' glycemic impact even more than simply pairing carbs with other nutrients. Again, super exciting to hear. And tell me if you notice this. 2 to 3 hours after eating a high carb meal, you feel hungry again, or even worse, you feel weak, sleepy, or dizzy. This could be due to reactive hypoglycemia, and it occurs after rapid absorption of carbs, followed by an insulin spike. Insulin will bring the glucose down, and that's when you feel hungry again. Or if the response is exaggerated, you'll feel more than just hungry. You might feel sleepy, tired, or even have a headache. A good way to get around this is to eat your non-starchy veggies like roasted, grilled, boiled raw, or your guacamole first, then add your proteins, chicken, fish, meat, and eggs before your carbs like rice, potatoes, pasta, corn, and fruits. So in other words, saving the bread basket for the end of your meal instead of the first thing you eat, which I know I'm guilty of because restaurants in America bring the bread basket out first. Especially during Thanksgiving, right? Ideally, you should start with turkey, gravy, and some of the veggie side dishes, and save the mashed potatoes and stuffing for the end. Doing this can potentially help you reduce insulin and glucose, which plays a big role in weight gain, and I hope I did enough to cover that. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys, though. What are your thoughts on food order? Do you think carbs should be eaten last? Do you think it even matters? Comment down below what you think. Subscribe if you found this video helpful, and I'll see you guys on the next one.